Hello! Hooray! He's kicked the ball. Now the ball's over there. That man has it now. That's an interesting development. Maybe he'll kick the ball. He has indeed, and apparently that deserves a round of applause.
Will you shut up? They're going to hear you.
This is the worst thing in the world.
What could I do? He bought the tickets on the phone when we were in the pub. I could hardly say no, could I?
Can I use this?
I don't know.
Come on, they're singing! They're singing! Maybe we should sing!
Just promise me we won't do anything else with them. I want to go back to being weird. I like being weird. Weird's all I've got. That and my sweet style.
Okay, look, we'll make our excuses when the match is over. How long do football matches last?
A billion hours, apparently.
Listen, we're going to play a little poker tonight. You boys game?
I'm in.
Must?
I won't then, no.
Come on.
No, can do. I'm seeing a bird.
Oh, really?
Yeah, why not?
What was she like?
Well, she's not much to look at, but she's very kind-hearted. So, as I say, I've got a vermouche.
Well, you're not watching it?
They're having a laugh today.
Well, they're winning.
Yeah, they're having a laugh.
Hello, Roy speaking.
What? Moss? You're still concussed. You need to see the doctor.
Who is this? Roy? Wait, it couldn't be Roy. I'm Roy.
Look, what does IT mean?
What?
IT, what does it mean? Someone's just asked me.
You don't know what it means?
No, I never thought to ask.
This must be Jen.
Yes.
Hello, Jen.
Hello.
How may I help you?
Oh, tell me what IT means.
Absolutely.
Well?
Very well, thank you. How are you?
Please just stay with me just for a simple question, OK?
Jen, I'm just going to put you on speakerphone.
No,
all right.
No, hang on.
Jen, you are now on speakerphone. Jen? Hello, Jen? Jen, can you bear with me one moment? I've got someone trying to get through on the other line. Roy speaking.
You just hung up on me.
Jen, can you hold on one second? I've got Jen on the other line. Jen, can I call you back? I've just got Jen trying to get through on the other line. Jen, sorry about that. Chicken in a basket. It has been all ruddy go today. Now, how may I help you?
What does IT mean? You know, computers. Something to do with computers, probably.
Computers? That's not really my area. Jen, I'd love to help you, but it's a real pain. I seem to have forgotten absolutely everything I know about computers.
How can you forget everything you know about computers, Moss?
Let me see. Maybe it isn't everything. No, it's definitely everything.
Tell you the truth, I think Delina might be sleeping with someone else.
No, she's just over there. So I'll hold up the beaker like, I've discovered something.
Exactly, yes.
But what have I discovered?
It doesn't matter.
I think it does a bit, actually.
Okay, you have discovered nuclear bombs.
In a beaker?
You're right, it's surprising. So give me surprised. Yeah, that's it. And it's confusing. Yes, you're confused. And you are afraid of the consequences of the discovery. Give me fear. Fear. Yeah, that's good. That's good. Okay, nice. Nice. And if you're hot or anything, Moss, maybe you could undo some buttons on your shirt.
No. I'm all right, thanks, Roy.
Maybe just undo your top button.
Why?
It's hot. It's a hot lab because of all the fusion.
Fission?
Fission, yeah. That's it. Maybe just one more button. Okay. That's good. And maybe you could, maybe you could get down on all fours.
Why?
Because you had some microscopic nuclear things and you dropped them. Big klutz.
Oh, nightmare.
Yeah. They're down there somewhere.
It's a pain. Oh, where are they?
Yeah. And you're getting angry.
Oh, well, I would.
Yes, because you can't find them.
Oh, grrr.
You know how you growl when you can't find stuff? That's it. And there are other people in the lab and they're being so noisy. Shh. That's it. And then it occurs to you that maybe you put your microscopic nuclear things in your back pocket.
Oh, did I? That's it. And why would they be there? And yet I put them there. It's strange.
You're working hard, you know, you're tired.
Oh, well, I've been busy.
Yeah, and they're being noisy again. Shush, go. Yeah. That's good, boss. Yeah.
My mum's on Friend Face, my mum. I've opened up another channel of communication with my mum.
Isn't that good?
No, it is not good. She's put down her current mood as sensual.
Why didn't you just not accept her as a friend?
What, are you an animal? I can't turn down a friend request from my mum.
Message for me.
I am eating my apple, mum. She packed me an apple this morning and it's the issue of the day.
Okay, let's try something. Let's do some role play. Okay, do you think that would be a good idea?
It certainly helped me learn how to buy sandwiches.
Okay. Let's go for it, okay? So I'll be those bullies on the bench.
What, all of them?
No, just one of them.
Which one?
I don't know them, Moss. I'm a bully on the bench, and you're going to walk past me, but this time, after I make a hurtful comment, come back at me with something. Okay, get all up in my shit. All right? Okay. Oh, no, wait. What do they usually say?
They mention my glasses.
Okay, let's start with that. Them glasses is shit, innit?
It's too real, Roy. It's too real.
I won't do the voice.
Thank you.
Okay. Nice glasses.
Maybe the reason I have to wear glasses is because I suffer from short-sightedness and I can't put contact lenses in because I'm frightened of touching my eyes. There's no way that there's these glasses I can't. And there's no. Yeah.
Yeah. Stupid hair.
Well, if someone called me a big ugly builder, I'd be furious. And not just because I'm actually an IT consultant. Revenge, that would be uppermost upon my mind. I'm going to wee on everything.
Oh, God.
I'm going to taint her abode.
Oh.
I'm going to strain my personal potatoes throughout her premises.
Oh, God.
Nice glasses.
Not as nice as your mama's glasses. Excuse me, I am trying to concentrate over here. And will you watch your ruddy language? My ears are not a toilet. I'm back.
What? What do you mean?
I'm back from holiday.
You were on holiday?
Yes, I was on holiday.
Oh, that's right.
Yes.
You didn't know I was on holiday?
No. We did. Where did you go?
You didn't know I was on holiday.
Oh, we did. We missed you.
I've been gone a week.
A week?
Wow.
Roy, can I have a natto with you? It's about private man's business. I'm sure you boys will understand.
Yeah.
Excuse me, please.
I've got a flipping gun! Bomb on the flipping gun! Bomb on the flipping gun!
A woman in the living room, a chef in the kitchen, a prostitute in the bedroom. Ow! Is this your stapler, Roy?
No.
No, it's not.
I used it for one thing.
How many staples did you use?
Six or seven.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, is that 7?
Why do you need to know?
I just do. I need to know. You know I need to know, and you never count how many staples you've used.
8, 9, if you didn't, 5, 5, 10, 10, is that 20?
There you go, Moss.
Right, Harry, did you see that ludicrous display last night?
What was they thinking, sending Walcott on early?
Thing about Arsenal is they always try and walk it in.
That is true.
See you later, Moss.
Well, there you go. Sometimes I could kiss your mind, Roy.
Okay, so let's just, let's just throw around a few ideas.
Okay.
Could we tell her that there's an apple inside every Apple Mac?
It's good.
Yeah.
We could say that Bill Gates is called Bill Gates because he owns a lot of gates.
That's good. It's not quite punchy enough. And it's probably true now anyway. I'll bet he does own a lot of gates.
He probably does.
It's gotta be something big.
I think I may have it.
What?
You'd best put seatbelts on your ears, Roy. Because I'm going to take them for the ride of their lives.
Chelsea, you're having a laugh, aren't you?
Well, I'll put money on it if you like.
No, I've already got a pony on Liverpool, so I probably won't see that again.
Sandwich.
Oh, right.
Coffee.
What? No!
Got you. That one's empty. This is the real one. I've been planning that for ages. The look on your face.
Yeah. What do you do, Moss?
I'm a professional tennis player.
Yeah, he doesn't like talking about it, though, so...
I do.
Where do you play?
Where don't I play?
Wimbledon?
I don't play there.
Are you seeded, Moss?
Bit of a personal question, Terry. But, yes, I'm highly seeded. We have two lovely children, Zenith and Quasar. Box fresh!